Hi, Bennett. How are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. Good to have you on Most Requested Live.
Oh, it's lovely to see you and 100 pictures of Elvis. That's cool.
It kind of looks like I'm in a fancy hotel bathroom right now, but this is our studio in Philadelphia.
I love it. And is your wife there?
She's not here, but she's
Is it true that you got married to a Coldplay song?
Sure did, to Green Eyes. That's our
song. Well, that's really cool to hear. Please send them my love, and I hope it's all going okay.
Most definitely, man. That's so good to hear from you. And I knew you would have been there to perform if it wasn't for COVID restrictions. I knew you would have been performing for us, right?
Absolutely. If it wasn't for COVID and for your lack of $8 million, I would have been there.
That's about, yeah, give or take, $8 million, right? Yeah, I'm a little short on that.
It's $8 million per song per wedding. So as of now, I've had no bookings.
One day soon.
One day someone will meet that price tag.
Yeah, I'll start saving. Good to have you on Most Requested Live. Congrats on Higher Power. This is a song I feel like we need right now.
Thank you, Bennett.
It's larger than life, which is fitting since you debuted the song in Freaking Outer Space. It's going to be hard to top that for future releases.
Yes, yes.
But this is a song, from what I understand, it started from your bathroom sink.
Yeah, not my bathroom sink, but a bathroom sink.
How? And, how does that happen? Walk me through it.
I think once you've been washing your hands for however long the government wants you to wash your hands, you're like, okay, I wonder what else I can do in this sink. And then you start hitting it as you would. And then you think, oh, wow, that sounds cool. Then you record it on your phone. Then you run to the nearest instrument and see if there's a song that wants to arrive. And that's what happened with Higher Power. But it's never happened on any other bathroom facility.
Yeah, does the bathroom get credit on the project?
Well, that is a great question about, you know, how much is a sink aware of itself? And my feeling is, I don't know if it would mind if we haven't credited it, but I am talking about it a lot.
Yeah. How often does it happen for you? Like when you're trying to come up with a melody or maybe something organic, like the bathroom sink play, how often does that happen where you're starting to come up with the lyrics and the sound and it just bottoms out before it really gets going? Like, is Higher Power really a gift? Like, does that happen?
Yeah, that's often? Yeah, good songs really are a gift, but they are surrounded with the corpses of ones that just didn't go anywhere. That probably were more, you know, I think if you're someone who works with songs, you have to be a bit of a craftsman, but you also have to be aware that good songs are coming from somewhere else, that you're channeling them or something like that. And so while you're waiting for a good one to arrive, you're trying to do your best as a little human. And those are the ones that don't make it. But the other ones wouldn't arrive if you didn't sit there chipping away all the time. Does that make sense?
Yeah. That next great song is right around the corner. Just right around all those dead corpses.
Yeah. I'm sorry, that was a little bit of a dark image. But sometimes little ideas will be, you know, littered around. But songs, we've only had maybe like 10 of them in our whole time. A song that sort of arrives fully formed, that sort of brushes everything else out of the way.
Now tell me about you guys' sound over the years. I've been a fan since the jump, since Parachutes. And then, so you go from there all the way to Everyday Life and now to Higher Power.
Yeah.
You guys have kind of bobbed and weaved and kind of morphed your sound a little bit from project to project, you know, kind of experimenting with new sounds. Do you think that metamorphosis was necessary for the band? And do you guys think you'd be as big or as relevant without, you know, experimenting and trying new things?
Well, that's a wonderful question, man. I'm trying not to do anything other than follow what feels like it needs to be done, like follow the muse, if you want. It just seems like there's always I'm really lucky, there's a very clear vision of, okay, we're supposed to go here. And sometimes that's really excited by new experiences or new sounds or listening to an artist I've never heard or something that's happened in my life that's different. And then, so there's just I feel like I and we are quite blessed in that we've always loved all kinds of music, which some people don't have. Some people really like, I have a brother, for example, who only likes heavy rock, and he's happy with that, you know, it's cool.
Right.
And I'm lucky that I can enjoy a Radiohead song and then a Britney Spears song and then a Lil Nas X song, and I think they're all great. So I think that that's a blessing of liking sort of fruit salads.
Exactly. Which leads me to, you said Britney Spears, which leads me to Max Martin, your first time collaborating with this mastermind.
Yes.
What was that collaboration like in your first time working with him? Why the wait?
Yeah. Well, I feel that we were probably headed towards each other for a long time, and it just never felt quite the right moment. And then one day it just felt like, okay, this is what we're supposed to do. And in a strange way, he sort of just joined the band, and it's been such a gift from God. He is really, I really like most of what we've done. I stand behind it. You know, there was one period where I didn't follow the muse so much, and I was a bit influenced by business things and all that, and that's my least favorite musical time. But with him, he's sort of making us sound like I was always hoping we would get to at some point. Does that make sense? One day I feel like we could sound a bit like this one day, but I don't know how to do that. And yeah. I think he's done that for us, with
Absolutely.
Us.
The song just comes alive through the speakers. And, you know, going to a Coldplay show is like an outer body experience. You know, from my perspective, it's like one of my favorite all time shows. And I'm trying to put myself in your shoes, you know, the past year and a half where there's been no concerts, you know, I think that's something we took for granted. Yeah. What is that like to perform night in and night out for years and years and years, having the audience recite and scream the lyrics at you? How do you suddenly replace the love and energy, you know, from performing live to not having that anymore? You know, what did you learn about yourself during the past year and a half?
Well, that kind of adrenaline is such a drug, and it's one I love it, and I would go back to that drug anytime. I have not like completely rehabilitated from that because I love it. But you know, honesty is, I had to look at like, okay, where do you get your self-worth from if you're not getting it? And this applies not just to being a musician, it applies in any form of life. Even if you're on Instagram looking for likes, that's the same thing. You know, and people who do my job tend to be hungry for approval for some reason. So I just wanted to look into a bit of like, okay, where does that come from, that need for external validation? And how can I live a little bit less dependent on that? Which has been a really healthy thing to do for me anyway.
That's great. As you know, Most Requested Live is the most interactive radio show on the planet. So we have some fan questions real quick. You know, there's been a rumor of a BTS Coldplay collab. The internet's freaking out about this. Mm-hmm. Is that just an internet rumor, or is there truth to that? The fans want to know.
Well, I don't really have an answer to that question, Bennett, except that I love that band, and I'll tell you why. Because first of all, I love what they stand for as people, and secondly, it just makes me so happy that the biggest act on the world is singing a lot in Korean. They're not like just that. It's just, to me, it's such a signal that world culture is moving in such a good direction, and that we can embrace things that are different. And I also love their songs. I just, you know, if that were ever to happen, if it was the right song for the right reason, I would be super into it, because, you know, I really believe in uniting all kinds of humans with each other.
Absolutely. World cultures, like you said, and just genres in general, I feel like 2021 is like a melting pot, which is so beautiful to see.
I mean, right now, there's so much separation in the world, and like, you can't go here and we're different to you. And there's a very loud voice in that corner. And so I'm interested in anything that's the other voice of like, no, we live on one planet, and there is no us and them. And we aren't different from someone who worships in a different way or something like that. We're the same type of thing. So that's what I believe in. And so if there was ever the right moment, I would definitely do something with them, because I love them, and I love what that would mean for us.
I love that. You just made a lot of people very happy with that response. Another fan question. This is really good because a lot of us gravitated towards your music during these trying times, right? To whether to cope or just to escape from real life. That's been me as a Coldplay fan all these years. What did you gravitate towards, you know, during the past year and a half? You know, who did you go to? What artist or band did you want to listen to just escape reality?
I'll tell you in a minute, man, but you say you've been with us since the beginning, but with all due respect, you only look about 21. How?
You are now my ultimate therapist.
No, I'm not trying to be all, you know, charming stuff. You really don't look like you've been alive as long as our band.
I'm 34.
Okay, man. Well, you're doing something right, you know, yeah, moisturizing wise.
Yeah. Pharrell is sharing his skin secrets with me.
Oh, well, if he's shared them, then you're going to look good till you're 107. what have I been gravitating to? Well, masses of music and TikTok and Instagram and like there's so many cool, there's a thing on Instagram called Dust to Digital, which every day shows some amazing new music that I've never heard of or someone performing some instrument I've never seen. And then all these artists doing paintings and then all the new dances and like there's so much life like firing out all the time. So I've gravitated towards that and gravitated towards going in the ocean whenever I can and like just being a little creature in the sea. And then music, of course, like who have I been really into? I got really into Frank Sinatra for a while and then Nina Simone and Etta James and yeah, all kinds of things. And then like Roddy Ricch, I think is completely amazing. Yeah.
Roddy Ricch. Yeah.
So I'm just, my mind is blown on a daily basis by how cool things and people can be.
Which comes out and, you know, through your music, which has just been so pleasant. Thank you for the time. I wish I could talk to you for the next, you know, half hour, but I know you have to run. But just congrats on Higher Power. This is such a special song and we just appreciate the few minutes.
Hey man, what a treat to talk to you. Send my love to your lady wife and I hope I'll see you again soon. All right.
Absolutely.
All right, Ben.
Thanks, Chris.
Thanks, man. Okay.